Hello and welcome to the SANFL Finals Footy Fix. My name's Zach Milbank and joining me today is North Adelaide coach Josh Franco. And Josh, you must be wrapped with the momentum you're taking into this preliminary final. You're outstanding again in the way you fought your way back in the first semi-final against the Eagles on Sunday.
Yeah, look, Zach, I think I've stood here for the last couple of weeks and talked about our final five games of the season where we were 0-5. And The group had lost confidence, we'd lost momentum, we'd lost... Well, almost like the wheels had fallen off, but to the guys' credit, they fought back and, you know, obviously we got the good result against Centrals in the elimination final. And you talk about that word momentum. With momentum comes confidence, and at the moment, the group, it is brimming with confidence.
Certainly seems a renewed spirit amongst the group as well. How would you describe that?
You know, it's interesting, Zach, when you talk about a renewed spirit, it was always there.
Okay.
You know, from a coaching point of view and a coaching staff's point of view, it was just trying to find it and, you know, to get that spark and to... metaphorically speaking, flick the switch. So the guys actually got the belief and the confidence back, which they've done. And as I said, that probably started in the first elimination final against Centrals a couple of weeks ago.
You obviously got to this point last year, winning your first two finals and then also met West Adelaide in the prelim, but just fell short. How do you go one better this time?
Yeah, look, I mean, how do you? Obviously, kick more goals is the simple answer. But I think if you looked at our group and... from last year's side, actually I haven't done the stats on it, but there's probably eight or nine guys that won't be playing Sunday that played the last prelim last year. You know, as a group, individually, and guys that come to mind are Nick Amato, you know, Maxi Thring, those types of players, they've got another 20 games under their belt, and they're better players than they were 12 months ago. We've added different guys to the mix. And ultimately, Zach, it's, you know, fingers crossed we can get the positive result.
Indeed. You talk about kick more goals. How do you think, I guess, you can achieve that given West Adelaide's renowned defensive tactics?
Yeah, look, absolutely. I mean, we've got some pretty good tall forwards. Fingers crossed that Lewis Johnson comes back into our side. Daniel Stewart didn't impact at all last week, and he had a bit of the flu and took that into the game, so he wasn't 100% fit, but we ran with him anyway. So you wouldn't expect him to have two quiet games in a row. Yeah. Tommy Langford's another guy who... he still does demand a pretty good matchup, and then you've got the Riswicks and Nathan Gordons who can also catch. So, look, ultimately, you know, we'll play West Adelaide and, you know, play to our strengths. Yep. Obviously, you're going to get first use of the ball, but quick ball movement should hopefully set us up.
You touched on Louis Johnston there. What's the latest with his ankle, and do you expect him to play?
Oh, look, who knows with Louis Johnston? I spoke to him, and I speak to him regularly. Look, the answer to the question is I still don't know. We probably won't know till sort of Friday morning, Friday lunchtime, I would have thought. In having said that, I'm very confident he'll play, without actually saying he definitely will.
A lot of people tend to forget that you're actually playing this final series without your captain, Greg Gorman, and also your joint vice-captain, Luke Ivins. As the season progresses week by week a little bit longer, are those guys any chance at all of returning, or are they done?
No, look, they're done. Lukey Ivins, 2 weeks ago, he hurt his hamstring, so he's done. Greg Gorman, actually, I think we've only had Greg for about three or four quarters for the whole year, so he's almost the forgotten one, isn't he? But you're right, he's an inspirational leader, but unfortunately we won't have him, we won't see him again this year. He's got a nasty elbow injury, so he's done as well.
Disappointing there for a couple of real true clubmen, but I'm certain that they'll be wishing you all the best and supporting you on Sunday here at Amy Stadium for the preliminary final against West Adelaide. All the best, Josh, and good luck.
Thanks, Zach.
Cheers.